In July 2020, the Minister for Local Government officially launched Fort Portal Tourism City after it was included among the 7 municipalities to be elevated to city status, including Barara, Gulu, Hoima, Lira, Arua, Mbale and Jinja. However, 2 years after the creation of these new cities, residents in Fort Portal City say they don't see a major transformation that they had hoped would come with this new status.
City yafu ya Fort Portal, olwalero, obane city ndala simanyi, olaba anti, level kwedi olwalero, even it is beyond a town council. Kwa webatu era city, ngatuwa municipality. Botunulia budget yaliye ya municipality. Nga municipality. Yaliye kavali nga population ya batu wabali municipality. Ne area obunene bwayo. Olabati budget yeyo wetuogiri la kakati. Bajisala no kujisala. Sentezi. Municipality ze yaliye funa. Kati sentezi batuwa. Kumpi ziri equivalent tu. Town council. Katiba kitegeeza ki nti kino site kiri mu biwandiiko. But in service, we are at the town council level.
Andrew Muhereza has worked in Fort Portal for more than 10 years now. He says the services the municipality enjoyed before attaining city status was better. According to Muhereza, the roads were better. He says then, the government was sending enough money for their construction, but currently there is no money to do the same job. The same narrative is shared by his fellow border cyclist, Arari Charigonza. The Fort Portal Division mayors in 2021 even contemplated closing their offices until the government starts funding them. Fort Portal Tourism City has 2 divisions, which include Central Division and North Division. But the leaders of these divisions say they have never been given any budget from the government to help them do their work. Haruna Chibirango, the Fort Portal Democratic Party chairperson, thinks the city status is just in name.
For example, Katinga from Divina Viapo. Singat Weba platform. Ukogeri Avantage Po. But it is okay. Nene government yafwe no eine nkola eyokumira abantu bafwe mbutamanya.
Fort Portal boasts of a number of tourism sites, including the roaring Nyakasura waterfalls, the dazzling explosion crater lakes that are more than 50 in number, Amabere Ganyinamuiru caves, Chibale National Park, ranges of Mount Rwenzori, Karambi Royal Tombs, and River Mpanga, among others. Nelson Touch, a tour guide based in Fort Portal, says although the benefits of the new tourism city have not yet come to fruition, there are a number of achievements that have been made.
July 2020, when Fort Portal became a city, our demand for tourism services in this region has increased. Since that time, we've gotten more clients than we had ever got. And the good thing in this is even the domestic travelers have increased. From 2020 to today, you can go to Sempai alone and you find, say, 500 people on a weekend, but 90% of those are Ugandans or East Africans, which is very good. And that has come about because everyone now is wondering, why is Fort Portal a tourism city?
Nelon says because of this, tourists in the region have increased, which has also forced different hotels to take their workers for training to meet the new standards and demands of a city status.
At least now people are trying to up their game. They're trying now to understand more. We've seen some hotels take their staff for extra training, especially in customer care and service generally.
Fort Portal Woman Member of Parliament Linda Irene Mugisa says although things look a bit slow right now, the government is advancing developments to better the city.
Cardinal role of government to ensure that they give services to the people, because as citizens, we are taxpayers and they need value for money.
Report by Junan Tusingwire for the news in Fort Portal.